Welcome everybody to a new video, and today we want to talk about a new IGN article that has just surfaced online in which they reveal some new details about Resident Evil Village. And I would like to just say that leading up to the release of the game, we now have even more information almost every day of the game. And that's great for Resident Evil fans, even though, you know, if you don't want to be spoiled, of course, maybe you shouldn't read into all of it. But for us, as devout Resident Evil fans, it is definitely a very exciting time with a mainline entry coming up. And in this article on IGN, we can see a very clear image this time of the map. It looks like this is an in-game screenshot of the actual map lying around on a table. We actually already knew about this map and we talked about it numerous times in our videos before, so there is a link in the description below and also to the top right if you want to check out that video specifically where we talk about all the locations. So you can see here the locations we already knew about. So you have Moreau's Reservoir, then you have Heisenberg's Factory, House Beneviento over here, and then Castle Dimitrescu over there. And then basically there is an endgame location, which is called the Stronghold over here. And those will kind of be the main locations. Now that is something that is kind of old news. It's still a nice screenshot, but kind of old news. But there is something else very exciting that we can see and read in this article on IGN. And what is that, David?
Yes, we're getting to see actually a confirmation for the first time how Mother Miranda will be portrayed in the game.
Yeah, that's right. So if you remember, Mother Miranda is a character in which one of the footage that we had of Resident Evil 8, you see Lady Dimitrescu having a phone call with this character. And it basically looks like this Mother Miranda character is pulling the strings in the background and is basically orchestrating the whole plot and the kidnapping also of Rosemary, or Rose, which is Ethan's daughter. We can now, for the first time in an officially released piece of art or render, we can see this character of Mother Miranda. And so the interesting thing is that this is not the first time that we see Mother Miranda, because in fact in the Maiden demo that has already been released on the PlayStation 5, which is basically a teaser of Resident Evil Village, you could already find a portrait of Mother Miranda over here. So it was actually in the teaser already, and players who paid close attention could already see this depiction of Mother Miranda over here.
Actually, there's some interesting new information in this article piece from IGN. So I'm quoting here, they're saying, "You can see villagers chanting her name in some kind of ceremony, and Lady Dimitrescu can be seen talking with her Mother Miranda over the phone."
And if we actually go way back to the second trailer, all the way back in September 2020, last year, we can actually hear those villagers also chant Mother Miranda. So that's very interesting. I didn't really notice that until now, but yes, they are really chanting Mother Miranda. And they also talk in the article why she is named Mother Miranda. And she's not named Mother Miranda only because she might be the mother of somebody, but also because in the religious sense, she is a mother of the religious cult, so of her followers. And that's why she is sort of mentioned as the mother, and that's really where mother in Mother Miranda stands for.
So yeah, once again, there's some interesting information in the IGN article. This time it's a quote by Takano, one of the directors of the game, and he says, "The mask resembles a crow's beak. As a symbol of horror, crows function as a theme for Village in its entirety as well, as they appear in the actual game. Since she has a symbolic role within the village, we implemented that same design theme for Mother Miranda."
And that's indeed, that really looks like that is the inspiration for Mother Miranda, because it really looks like her mask resembles some kind of crow. And it's really intriguing, because who is the person behind this mask? Is it already a known Resident Evil character, or is it a completely new character? At this moment, that is really unclear. We don't know if this is an established Resident Evil character or not. But it's definitely interesting to speculate a little bit in this direction, because if you remember from Resident Evil 7, the end game character of Evelyn, so the end boss of the game, was also a shape-shifting human that could shape into different characters, different forms, eventually into a gigantic monster. So perhaps Mother Miranda can shapeshift into different forms. For example, we see all these feathers being referenced in the art. Does that mean that Mother Miranda, for example, can shapeshift into different animals like crows? And perhaps she is also exerting her influence over these villagers in a different form. For example, this grandmother, old shaman lady that we can see in the trailers, is that perhaps a form of Mother Miranda? That could very well be that Mother Miranda is such a kind of shapeshifter and that she is basically everywhere in the game all at once.
Yeah, and also really would be that they're combining like Resident Evil 4 with Resident Evil 7 into Resident Evil Village, and that would just make a lot of sense.
Yes, indeed. It looks like they're taking elements and cues from both of these fantastic games, Resident Evil 4 and Resident Evil 7. So, and with that said, we've come to the end of this video. Now, don't forget, on April the 15th, there will be a new Resident Evil showcase where Capcom will show new gameplay and release new information about Resident Evil Village. And if you are curious what's going to be in the stream, be sure to tune in, because we will live stream this showcase on our channel. So be sure to be here for that live stream. And with that said, I would like to thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.